first step in the aluminum microchannel heat exchanger repair procedure is to locate the damaged area and verify that there is actually a leak using industry standard practices. Please note, the tube construction is capable of withstanding a hard impact as long as the impact is not sharp and does not cut the tube. Next, it may be necessary to remove some of the air fin to gain access to the damaged area. Using needle nose pliers, remove the fins above and below the tube needing repair. The fins to be removed should be approximately 25 millimeters either side of the repair location. Please note, the fin can be removed by grabbing the fin with the long nose pliers and slowly tearing the fin away from the tube. However, please use caution when working with sharp objects around the refrigerant tubes. Remove all foreign debris around the damaged area with a small stainless steel bristle brush. Use care to avoid contaminating the damaged area. Thoroughly clean the area with a mild soap, such as a dish liquid and water mixture. Next, rinse the area with clean water. Using a MAP or oxyacetylene gas torch, very carefully evaporate the water. Repeat the washing procedure, attempting to flood the refrigerant ports with soapy water. Rinse with clean water and again dry the area with the torch. The torch should eliminate all moisture and contaminants, but a steady-state vacuum can be pulled on the system after the repair to ensure no moisture remains in the system. Place a metal heat shield around the damaged area to protect adjacent tubes and air fins. If the coil must be repaired at an angle or in a vertical orientation, create a heat shield with tabs that will extend into the fins of the coil. Mount the heat shield onto the coil using the tabs to hold it in place. Adjust the torch tip to a neutral or rich carburizing flame and apply heat to the edge of the damaged area. Place the end of the braze wire against the damaged area and gradually heat the edge of the tube until the material wicks into the tube ports. The coil tube walls are very thin and it is possible to burn through the tube wall if excessive heat is applied. Finally, allow the area to cool and remove the heat shield. Using tin snips or shears, cut a portion of replacement air fin equal to the length previously removed. Apply the instant adhesive to the replaced air fin to hold it in place. Lastly, paint the repaired area to protect against corrosion. The system may now be charged with refrigerant and operated normally.